chant was invented, I felt special. I felt like that was mine. Yeah, you know what? No. Now Dave Schiff's getting it, Gene Peckham's getting it. That is my chant. Alright, you guys come up with other ones for these other people. We've worked really hard. Again, I mean, I say this every time, but 5 days is a ridiculously short amount of time. These guys have worked really hard. But I also really need to talk about how hard the crew works. Jeff, Matt, and Rashab have not had a day off since orientation. They've been in the theater every night till about 2 a.m. making sets and costumes. I don't know how they do it. It's pretty ridiculous. If you see them around camp, thank them for their hard work. I found a script version of it in a theater bookshop over the winter, and I thought, wow, it would be really fun to do this at camp. It's a boys' adventure story, and I thought it would be a lot of fun. These guys have worked incredibly hard. They've made it a lot of fun as well. I'm really excited to present American Eagle's production of Pinocchio!
My travels took me to a quaint little village. It was a beautiful night. As I wandered along the crooked streets, there wasn't a soul to be seen. The only sign of life was a lighted window in the shop of a woodcarver named Geppetto. So, naturally, I hopped over and looked inside. I didn't know what to expect. There was shelf after shelf after shelf of books and old toys. But then, something else caught my eye. A puppet. You know, one of those marionette things. You pull strings and you would you little fellow.
Well now, it should not take them much longer. Just a little bit more of paint then. Perfecto. Now I have just a name for you. Little Wooden Head. Or Pinocchio for a short. Now, let's try you out. Would you like that? Let's pick it up. Slow it down for the ladies. I'm a little tired of this dancing. It isn't getting late. We should get some rest. He almost looks alive. Wouldn't it be nice if my Pinocchio might one day be a real boy? Oh well, come, let's get some rest. Look, Pinocchio, a shooting star. You know what they say about those shooting stars? you can grant wishes. And I only wish that my Pinocchio might one day be a real boy. Just a thing. A real boy. Come, let's get some rest.
It was a very lovely thought, but not at all practical. I mean, how could a puppet become a real boy? Who ever heard of such a thing? What's that? What's going on? What's happening? This is way too much excitement for a little cricket.
Oh, but Geppetto, you have given happiness to so many others. You deserve for your wish to become true. Little boy made of wood, awake. The gift of life is yours.
Phew! What they can't do these days. Very nicely done, miss.
Thanks.
I can move. I can talk. I can walk.
Of course you can. I've given you life.
Am I a real boy?
No, Pinocchio. In order for Geppetto's wish to become true is entirely up to you. You must prove yourself brave, truthful, and unselfish, and one day you will be a real boy.
A real boy?
That wouldn't be easy. To become a real boy, Pinocchio would have to learn to choose between right and wrong.
That's right, little Creaky Poo. You're so cute with your little nose. But yes, you would have to learn between right and wrong.
I will have to learn to choose between right and wrong? But how will I know?
How would he know?
How would he know? I got it. Jiminy Cricket here will be your conscience. He'll guide you down a straight, narrow path.
What? But, great, another job. And I was just about to take a nap. Hey, do I get a badge or something?
No. No badge. There's only one badge in this town, and that's Big Mama. Remember, Pinocchio, be a good boy, and always let your conscience be your guide. Always let your conscience
be
your guide.
Wait, but what if he... No, but always if I...
Well, kid, maybe it's time you and I better have a little heart-to-heart talk.
Why?
Well, you do want to be a real boy, don't you?
A real boy.
Yeah, settle down, kid. Here, take a seat. Now, you see, the world is full of temptations. They're the wrong things that may seem right at the time. But even the right things may seem wrong sometimes. Sometimes wrong things may be right at the wrong time. Or vice versa. Understand?
A real boy.
Yes, kid, a real boy. Now, are you listening? Did you hear what I said?
Yes, and I'm gonna do right.
Attaboy, Pinocchio, and I'm gonna help you.
Who's there? Who's in my shop?
It's me.
You're talking. Yeah, and I can move, too.
No, you cannot. I must be a dreaming, that is it. I am a dreaming in my sleep. Oh, please, wake me up.
Gee, Daddy, you're hilarious.
You really are talking.
Mm-hmm. The blue fairy was here.
The blue fairy.
And I got a conscience, too.
A conscience.
And someday, I'm gonna be a real boy.
Hey, little man, you had a busy night.
This is unbelievable. A dream come true. But now, Pinocchio, you must lie your head down and get some rest.
Why?
Because tomorrow you start your life as a real boy. Tomorrow I'm going to take you to school so you can learn things and get real smart.
Why?
Because that's what a little boy do.
And I'm going to be a real boy.
Yes. Now please lie down. Good night, Pinocchio.
Good night, Papa.
Good night.
Thank you.
our boss.
Yeah, our boss. And he's not happy.
Why? What did he say?
He said, I am not happy.
Why?
Because we haven't been getting enough money lately.
Well, the life of a con artist is very tricky. There isn't always someone around who can fool.
Huh? Well, we'll need to find someone that'll bring us drunk always some money. Moolah!
Cashola! Alright, let's just look around. What do we see?
What do we see?
What do we see? Listen. The merry laughter of little innocent children making their way to school.
Making their way to school. School?
Thirsty little minds.
Rushing to the fountain of knowledge.
School, a noble institution. What would the world be without it?
Come on, Pinocchio. You do not want to be late for your first day of school. Now here's your apple for the teacher, and here are your books. Be a good little Pinocchio and come straight home from school. Goodbye, Pinocchio.
Goodbye, Papa.
A little wooden boy.
Little wooden boy. A little wooden boy.
Look, it's amazing.
Amazing.
A live puppet.
Without strings. A thing like that would be
worth a fortune to Stromboli!
You see, Vivian, as I was saying to the Duchess.
Excuse my friend. He's so.
Clumsy. My.
Oh.
I hope you're not injured.
Oh, I'm all right.
He's all right.
He's all right. Oh, splendid. Quite a scholar, see? Look at all these books.
Yeah, that's a lot of books. He must be very smart.
I'm sure he's very smart.
I'm going to school.
School?
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 And you haven't heard of the easy road to success.
The easy road.
No, I haven't.
No?
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 I'm speaking, my boy, of the theater.
The theater. Here's your apple. Bright.
Bright lights.
Music.
Applause.
Fame.
Fame?
Yes, with that personality.
That profile.
That presence.
Why, you're a natural born actor.
But I'm going
straight to the top. Why even see your name in the list? Like 6 feet high. What is your name?
Pinocchio.
Pinocchio. P-I-N-K-Y. P-I-N-K-Y. Pinky is a tough guy.
Wait till practice time here.
What's your name?
You can call me Honest John.
Come on to the theater. You! Fine conscience, I turned out to be. Late the first day. Well, he couldn't have gotten too much trouble between home and school. Is that? Wait, Paul, hold on there.
Oh, hello, Jiminy. I decided instead of going to school, I'm going to be an actor.
Just what a parent wants to hear. What? Pinocchio, that's a terrible idea. You remember when I told you about temptation? Well, that's him.
No, that's Honest John.
Honest John? Boy. Okay, here's what we tell him. We say, you can't go to the theater. You're sorry, but you've got to go to school.
But I want to go to the theater. I'll go to school tomorrow. I promise.
No, Pinocchio, it doesn't work like that. You have to... Oh, no! What'll I do? Okay, I'll run and tell his father. No, that'd be snitching. What should I do? I know. I'll go after him myself. Pinocchio!
And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the almighty, great, most glorious performer in all the land, the giant, the colossal, the one and only Stromboli!
Ladies and gentlemen, please don't leave. I assure you that our grand finale will be worth staying for. Where have you been?
We've got something for you.
It's better be good, because you're on thin ice.
It's better than good. It's great. It's a wooden boy puppet without strings attached.
Are you kidding me with this?
No, Honest. Listen, put him in the big marionette number. He'll be great. Trust me.
Trust you?
Trust me.
Fine. You get him ready while I introduce the act. Ladies and gentlemen, the
hold me down to make me free or make me frown. I had strings, but now I'm free. There are no strings on me. They like me. They really like me.
You're sensational. You're colossal.
Does this mean I'm an actor?
Sure. I will push your face so far in the public's eyes, your face will be on everybody's tongue.
Gee, thanks. I'll run straight home and tell my father.
Home? Oh, sure. Going home to tell your father. Oh, that is very comical.
Oh, hello.
Hello, Pinocchio.
Leaving so soon?
I don't think so. This will be your home now. This way I can always find you.
No, no, no.
Yes, yes, yes. You belong to me. You and me will tour the world. London, Paris, Monte Carlo, Constantinople.
No.
Yes. We start tonight. You will make lots and lots of money for me. And when you are too old, you will make good firewood.
Let me out of here. You can't keep me. I can't be here.
Quiet. Shut up before I knock you silly. Good night, my little winning gold mine.
Oh, what have I done? Jiminy, help. Jiminy Cricket, where are you? Help.
It is so late. And my poor Pinocchio is not at home yet. I sure do hope he's okay. Perhaps I should go looking for him. I will need my cloak. And my lantern. Don't worry, Pinocchio. We will find you. Pinocchio! Pinocchio! Pinocchio? Pinocchio, excuse me, it's my boy Pinocchio.
Perhaps you were tricked into performing and then stuck in this cage.
Is that more like it?
Yes, miss. I'm sorry. I'll never lie again, I promise.
Now, miss, you know, Your Honor, Miss Barry, perhaps you could give him one more chance, you know, for my sake.
All right. But Pinocchio, you have to start making decisions to decide between right and wrong. I'm ashamed of you, Jiminy.
What? Me? But it was him, and I told him, and then...
Remember, Pinocchio, a boy made of wood might as well be good. And for this cage, good luck, Pinocchio.
Jiminy, look, my nose, it's back to normal.
Good, but let's just go home. Your father must be worried sick.
Goodbye, Mr. Stromboli.
What? Let's get out of here before something else goes wrong.
Thanks, Blueberry.
Okay. tells me what's right and wrong.
What? You mean you take orders from a grasshopper?
A grasshopper? Why, you really dumb pup! It wouldn't hurt you to take orders from a conscience if you had one.
Yeah, sure.
Why, you little hoodlum! Well, I'm Dr. Blocko, and I'll tear you apart and...
Jimmy, stop! He's my best friend!
Your best friend? And what am I, just your conscience? That's it. You clearly don't appreciate me for who I truly am. I'm leaving.
But Jimmy...
No! You buttered your bread, now sleep in it. Go on, left! This is the end!
But Jimmy, Lampwick says a guy only lives once.
Lampwick? Who's your conscience anyway? Me or that Lampwick ruffian? That's it. You're on your own, Mr. Wooden Boy.
You hear that beetle talk? You think something bad is going to happen to us? Conscience. Oh, Philly, where does he even get that nonsense? How do you expect to be a real boy? If you want to be a real boy, you just do this.
What is it?
Who cares? Just drink it.
I don't know. Jimmy does know a lot about what's right and wrong, and well...
Jimmy, you're listening to an insect. Come on, just drink it.
Okay.
Come on, drink like a real boy. There we go. And how does it feel?
Once it hits your lips, it tastes so good. Oh, eww! Oh, what's happening? What have you done?
Sorry, kid, I turned you into a donkey.
But, eww! Why would you do that?
You said it yourself. It's fun to be bad.
But, eww!
Sorry, kid, see you around.
Oh, help! Help! Somebody help! Eww! I've been double-crossed! Help!
I sure do hope my Pinocchio's okay. We have to find him. I will search day and night. London Sea. Do not worry, my boy. We are coming. Pinocchio! Pinocchio! Pinocchio? Pinocchio? Pinocchio! Pinocchio! Hey, it's weird, guys. You see Pinocchio?
Shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on you.
Me.
Yeah, you.
No, you're supposed to say me.
Yeah, whatever.
Please.
I think he's being sincere this time.
I just let him out of the cage and stopped for his nose from going. And now you want me to do this? No.
Please.
No.
Aren't you supposed to be forgiving?
Yes, but there are limits. I'm not an idiot. I just don't think Jiminy wants to be a real boy.
What?
No, you've hurt my feelings.
Oh, but I'm sorry, Blue Fairy. I didn't mean to upset you.
It's just that I thought things would be different. I thought you'd be nice and selfless, and you'd become a real boy, and we'd hang out. Just you, me, Geppetto, and the cricket, and we'd be friends. But it's ruined now. It's just ruined. I don't even know you anymore.
Shh, it's okay. Don't cry, Blue. You're my girl, Blue. You're my girl.
It can never be like that. Never.
Sure it can.
Get off my wings.
Sure it can. It can. Just please get rid of the donkey ears and we can start all over, fresh.
I don't know. I've been hurt before.
I know you have. I know.
His name was Peter. We were gonna get married on top of a mountain and have little fairy children that would form a family band. But a week before the wedding, he left me for some younger fairy. You know, the green one. Damn you, Tinkerbell. I hate her so much.
Let it out, it's okay.
With her stupid wings and annoying little buzzing sound. I can't even do it, but it's so annoying.
It's okay, you're okay.
I'm okay, I'm okay. That was good to get that out.
It's okay, I know Tinkerbell. I've never liked her either.
Thanks. Coming from you, that means a lot.
Now, miss, perhaps you could see it somewhere in your heart to remove the donkey ears?
I can never stay mad at you guys. Just remember, Pinocchio, you have to start making mature decisions.
I know.
Very well, then.
Now please, Blue Fairy, I have to get home and see my father.
Oh yeah, I probably should have told you, your father's not home.
What? Where's Mr. Geppetto?
He was so afraid when you didn't come home last night that he went out looking for you. He thought something had happened. He even sailed out to sea in a little wooden ship looking for you.
What? Where is he?
I'm afraid he was swallowed by a whale.
Swallowed by a whale?
Swallowed by a whale. A whale named Monstro, but he's alive.
Alive? Where is he?
Inside the whale, at the bottom of the sea.
The bottom of the sea?
That's what I said.
We've got to find him.
Did you hear what I said? He's inside a whale, at the bottom of the sea.
I don't care. I'm gonna save him. He's my papa.
Let me get this through your little head. He's inside a whale named Monstro, which rhymes with monster or monstrous, meaning large. He swallows ships whole. It's way too dangerous.
I don't care how dangerous it is. I'm gonna save him.
Sounds pretty selfless to me.
Are you coming, Jiminy?
Sure. I do enjoy seafood.
Perhaps I can help. Good luck, Pinocchio!
Away!
coming up soon. I'm afraid we are done for. Maybe he just needs a little motivation. Come on, Pinocchio. Come on, Pinocchio. Open up. Open up, I say. It's working. It's working. Fish, our glorious fish. We can eat our tuna fish. Keep them a-coming. Keep them a-coming. Here comes the big one. Oh.
Now where are we? Father? Father!
Pinocchio, please do not bother me.
Pinocchio? Father!
I'm so glad to see you.
Me too.
You want to soak your wet?
Two.
Nine.
Oh, yes, Father.
Well, why are you here?
We came to save you, Father.
Came to save you? Pinocchio, that was such a bad idea. Why did you come down here?
But, Father!
I am glad to see you. And you too, Junior.
Hello, Mr. Geppetto. Now, please. Let's just go home. How do we get out of here anyway?
Get out? There is no getting out. I have tried every other way. I even built this raft.
A raft? That's it?
Huh?
We'll climb aboard the raft, and when the whale opens his mouth...
No, that would not work. Because when the whale opens his mouth, everything comes in, nothing goes in.
Oh, it's hopeless!
Yes, it is hopeless. Now, let's just cook some of the fish and have a nice dinner.
A fire, that's it?
Yeah, but we also have a nice dinner.
A great big fire with lots of smoke.
Smoke? Ah, yes. Smoked the fish tastes really good.
Quick, some wood.
What's a chair, Pinocchio? What are you doing?
Hurry, Father, more wood.
What are you doing? Why are you trying to sit down?
We won't need it, Father. We're getting out.
Getting out? But how?
We'll make him sneeze.
Make him sneeze? Mamma mia, Pinocchio, that is the worst idea I've ever heard.
But, Father, it's the only way.
It's working! It's working!
Hurry, run forward!
Wait for me!
Here we go!
We'll never get the Bible, please!
Yes, we will! Paddle!
Achoo!
Pinocchio.
my brave, brave Pinocchio.
He certainly tried, Mr. Geppetto.
And for what? What have I ever done for him?
You created him, Mr. Geppetto.
Little bit has done him now. Oh, my poor, poor Pinocchio.
It's so sad. It's just so sad.
I'm sorry, miss, but we are closed.
That's the Blue Fairy.
Yeah, the Blue Who?
Be nice to her. She has magical powers.
Oh. Why, hello there. How you doing?
Why, hello.
I'm sorry I'm not in a better mood, but my Pinocchio was taken from me, trying to save my life.
Prove yourself brave, truthful, and unselfish, and someday you will be a real boy.
A what?
I'm sorry, I was talking to Pinocchio. Pinocchio? Oh, wait.
Father, what you crying for?
Because you're a dead Pinocchio.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. Now lie back down.
But, but Father, I'm alive, see? And I'm a real boy.
You are alive, and you are a real boy.
Yay!
High five.
This is called for a celebration with lots of music.
And dancing.
What was your name again?
They call me the Blue Fairy.
Well, let's bounce, Blue.
Well, that's practically where I came in. You certainly deserve to be a real boy, don't you think? And to all of you out there, although our story has reached its ending for now, I hope that every one of you in turn will realize, as I did, that dreams really do come true.
When your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, your dream comes true. You'll find your dream come true.
When your heart is upon a star, your dreams come true. You'll find your dreams come true.
steps in and sees it.